here in this room, but in the whole auditorium complex, you will have colleagues in the other auditorium. So we will probably approach 1,000 participants. I think this is fantastic. Can you hear me now?
Better? Okay. I'm very happy to stand here. I think that you all know that we face the same challenges. In fact, we do face the same challenges and share them with our Chinese friends and colleagues and with everybody on this very, very small planet that is called the only livable planet so far. 7 billion people. Aarhus University is engaged with the world. We have friends and colleagues all around us. In those countries, we have more than 800 agreements with other institutions, and we are now working at deepening the partnership in this network. See, this university, like I think all other global institutions, need to organize ourselves in such a way that we can contribute more to the to meet the needs of our societies. And we know that the world is globalized. We know that all the challenges are interconnected. They also transgress boundaries between the disciplines and between the nations. You can think about some of the challenges: food security, water quality, energy sustainability, demography and migration, public health, transnational economies, leading to stability, security, and climate change. Is all one of the same types of challenges that we face and you will have to find solutions to in the future. See, this university has been growing stronger. Now we are approaching
an annual budget of about $1 billion, and we have a lot of students. Some of them, few of them, are here, more than 40,000. We produce a lot of knowledge that is sent out to the international community. We have a lot of facilities and so forth. See, this is not only a university, it's also a corporation. And it's probably one of the only universities in Europe that is a corporation. We have a university on one side, you see the light blue side of this diagram, and we have a business to the other side. And these two sides of the corporation is very, very tight connected. Again, many students, but if you look at the business side of our corporation, the balance is almost the same as inside of the university. So it's very, very different from all other Danish universities, and certainly most, by far the most of all other European universities. So we think maybe a little bit more like a corporation that has different divisions. If we are, some people don't like to call themselves world-class, we don't hesitate in calling us a world-class university. Our American friends, they say that the world-class group of universities is about 150 universities. At this moment, we are right in the middle of that group, about number 80, if we weigh all the different ranking lists together. And if we are continuing the development of the university with the same speed as we do today, we will be in the top 50 group of global universities in 2020. We are not shy of having high goals, and you can just walk outside and this building, you will see this sculpture. We have developed a new model for a university. Research and education are the two traditional cornerstones, and the knowledge exchange with society is the third one. But we also think that talent development increasingly will become one of our corner stones of the activities. Think about the doctoral program, PhD program, but we will think on talent development in a much, much more profound sense from day one when you start at the university to when you leave. We will try to do something for the best talent also, which is maybe a new paradigm for a Danish educational system. We're not shy about talking about it. We don't have all the solutions yet. And we are also engaged with the global challenges. This is one of our field stations in Greenland. We have three in Greenland. This is Sakenberg near Daneborg in northeast Greenland. We think that a global university should also provide something to the global common good. So some of our research facilities are reaching out to everybody, for example, the stations in Greenland. So we have agreements with China, with Canada, with South Korea and the United States on sharing facilities when it comes to studying the Arctic. We also know that interdisciplinarity is something that is not to talk about, is a reality. We have to find solutions to interdisciplinary challenges. And this is one of the reasons why we are trying to establish interdisciplinary research centers. At the moment we have 7 and we have resources to maybe run about 10 of those. A lot of national centers of excellence are slightly smaller size. We also like to stimulate what is becoming the products of the future. I have one example here in our interdisciplinary nanoscience center. They are studying how the mussel, the blue shell mussel that we, some of you like when you go to Brussels or somewhere else and have mul, marinara or something like that, how do they fix themselves to the substrate? How can they underwater fix themselves to a nylon string or something like that? We have figured out how to do that, and some of our scientists have already taken out the patents. It may be the glue for the future, the glue that can have steel and plastic glued together. I think we have the patent for that here. Also the substance that can stop bleedings in the body when we are getting operated will probably come out of this research project. Glue for the future, in a little while it will be on the shelves of Fertix and other businesses. In summary, I think this is a modern university. We are responsive to the changes of our societies. We feel responsibility in a global network. We are willing to take on also leadership from time to time in the global networks, and we do that. It has a price, but we do it. I think we are active in the innovation networks, and we are willing to challenge the current paradigms also in our own countries. What is a good university education for 25% of the population? Should we differentiate within the 25%? Should we have better and stronger links to the other parts of the educational system? And of course the answers are yes, we should. The difficulty is how can we do it in a fair way? So thank you very much and congratulations once again. I wish you all the best for this wonderful event.